Hey everyone, welcome to PinLearn's product walkthrough. First, I would like to explain what are the core functions that our solution offers. So it's a marketplace online tutoring software that helps you to run your tutoring business. You can run after school market, after school tutoring, or online coaching, or any sort of consultancy business. So it offers your students to take live classes, be it one-on-one live classes and group live classes. And it also offers where your tutors can sell on-demand courses, like a self-paced course, just like in Udemy, where your tutors can pre-record the course materials and upload them so that the students can purchase and get access to it instantly. Okay, so this is the product demo, and it's the homepage where your students land on. And here on the homepage, you have the search where your students can enter any of the categories to search for tutors. So let me show you. I search for music, and it's going to show up the tutors who are going to teach music. Okay, and here you can find the list of tutors who are teach music. And then going back to homepage, you can find the top categories, and you can click on any of the categories to find tutors on that specific category. And then here you find the recent group classes which are published by the tutors, and their timings, the date, everything, the price and everything. And here are the self-paced courses, recently published self-paced courses by the tutors. You can find the categories which it belongs to, and yeah. And here you can, as a platform owner, you can feature your tutors to appear them on the homepage so that they get more exposure than the other tutors. And here you can load the testimonials from your parents and the kids so that that gives more trust factor to your platform. And here are two simple blocks that explains about how your platform works and inviting your tutors to become, become the tutor on your platform, just inviting anyone to become a tutor and sign up on your platform. So these are two simple pages that explains about your platform and inviting your tutors to sign up on a platform. So here, this is just a normal static page where you explain about your platform or the business that you're doing, the functions that is available on your platform. So this page is especially for the students to learn more about your platform, right? And then the Teach With Us page explains about what you're offering for the tutors who sign up on your platform. And yes, and then that's it for the homepage. And here are the list of tutors on your platform. So you can, as a student, they can filter tutors by grades, by categories, subjects, topics, availability of their dates, and by country and by zip code. So the categories, subjects, and topics are connected closely, which means that, see, for example, let's say I choose yoga, and you can find tutors who teach yoga. And then by subject, yoga, under yoga, there's a fitness subject, and under fitness, there are chair yoga, all these things. So I click on this, I find this specific tutor who teaches this specific topic. Right, so I can go on to a tutor profile. So this is the tutor profile page where I can see the reviews and ratings. I can see the total number of learners. And I can see the languages that she speaks. I can send a message, favorite. I can see her one-on-one calendar, her group classes, her courses. And these are the great subjects categories which she teaches. And this is a resume. And this is her about me section. And these are the group classes that the tutor teaches. These are the courses that is offered by the tutor. And this is the reviews and ratings by the students on this specific tutor, right? And I go on to a one-on-one page, which is appointments for one-on-one. And I can see that she offers both paid classes and free trial classes. If I choose free trial classes, it shows that the maximum number of free trial classes you can take is 5, which the tutor has set. So I choose a paid class. I choose the list of categories which he teaches, let's say marketing. I choose content marketing, and I choose email marketing plan, which means $23 per hour. So these are the available slots which the tutor has. So I can click on any of these slots and book the one-on-one class with a specific tutor, right? And the group classes, again, I can search any group class. I can search by filters, by price, by grades, by topics and everything. right? So I go on into any of the group class. So this is a group class detail page. It shows total number of participants or the maximum number of students for the specific group class is 30 and number of participants is 0. Let's say if two students book, it will show as two students, participants as 2 and remaining slots as 28. And this is a prize. I can either book or gift a course to another student. Right. So it's a multi-day group class. The group class can be single day group class or a multi-day group class. This is a multi-day group class. You can see the available slots for this specific group class from the specific tutor. And this is the tutor. This is about me section. This is the tutor ratings and reviews from different students, right? And showing you a sample course. Okay. So this is a course page. And this is just an intro video of the course. These are information about what you'll be learning on the course. So you can buy a course, it's just $7. This is the course content. So you can just preview the course content as in like what is inside the course content. These are sections, there are two sections and under each section there are multiple lectures inside it. So it can be audio, it can be video, it can be PDF, document, everything, right? So this is the description of the group class, reviews and ratings about this specific tutor, right? Okay, so this is an overview of how the platform or how the solution is going to look for the student. And also one more thing is that the platform supports multi-language. So you can set up the language from the admin backend and it can work in multiple languages. Now coming to the signup page. So here's the signup page. And for the student, the signup is pretty simple. You set the time zone, a name, email, password, and you sign up as a student, right? For the tutor, if someone signs up as a tutor and they choose this option tutor, it's gonna ask for a couple more information, just an introduction video where your tutor can introduce themselves so that, because every tutor who signs up on your platform need an approval process from the admin. So they have to introduce them and provide a couple of information like their tutoring experience, certifications, resume, and other things. So all these informations are collected when they sign up as a tutor. So it's just a small introduction video. They can upload a video file or they can even link it from the YouTube, right? And this is a verification document and this is a resume, this is a certifications, all these things they upload and then they sign up. Once they sign up, tutor goes into an approval process. Admin verifies all these information and if he's okay, then admin approves the tutor. Once the tutor is approved, then she'll be able to log into her tutor dashboard. Now, moving on to, so the whole video, I'm gonna split it into different sections. First, I'm gonna show you a student dashboard, like in how the student signs up and what are the options that the student dashboard provides for a student. And then I'm gonna show you a tutor dashboard, what are the options that is available for the tutor. And then I'm gonna show you the admin dashboard and what are the functions available for an admin to manage the entire platform, right? So yeah, so now this is understood. Now moving on to the student dashboard. Okay, here I have logged in as a student. I have signed up already as a student and I have logged in as a student. Let me show his profile. So this is student Pranav and this is student Pranav's profile. Here you can see the student's profile information like the name, email, gender, phone number, address, PayPal, email ID. This PayPal email ID here is for, let's say a student is requesting for a refund and he can request for a refund and the admin can pay out the refund either to the student's card details or whichever format the student has paid. Or if the student likes to get a refund on his PayPal, then he can request for the refund on his PayPal. So that's the reason that the system is asking for the PayPal email ID from the student. This is the time zone which the student sets. Whatever the time zone which the student sets, based on that, the notifications and all the email notifications, booking appointments, everything appears based on the time zone which he has set. The student can turn off or turn on the notifications for the emails and he can change the password. He can invite his friend. And this is information about the student. He has personal description, profile description. And this is a course certificate. So for example, if a student completes a course, like a self-paced course, so let me show you a self-paced course, which he has purchased. So here you can see that the student has purchased, this student, Pranav, as I'm logged into student, has purchased this course. So it shows as purchased. So I go into this course and I can see that this course has been already purchased. And yeah, so this is a course content. I can look into the course content. I can play a video and I can read the document, PDF, whatever the tutor has uploaded. And yeah, so once the course content, the course is completed, once the course hits progress 100%, the student can get a certificate. The certificates are automatically generated with the tutor's name and the platform's logo and everything can be accessed over here. So he can view the course certificate over here. You can see that the name has been printed. From the instructor, this is the tutor's name, Alan. This is a certificate that the student name completed the course title on the particular date. And this is the platform's logo. So it automatically generates a certificate and the certificate is available for the student. So the student can save as a PDF or, you know, he can keep it, access the certificate anytime from his student dashboard. So this is a student profile and this is a dashboard homepage where this is a student dashboard homepage. These are like the quick links where he can access to all these pages from his homepage. This is a message option. The student can message a tutor and he can initiate the message and then he can chat with the tutor anytime he wants. So this is the chat option for the student. And this is a profile. The student can favorite a tutor. He can favorite a group class. He can favorite a course. So all his transactions, be it a one-on-one booking or a group class booking or a course booking, all the transactions can be listed on this page, will be listed on this page and can be easily accessible for the student. He can see that he has booked a group class, he has booked a one-on-one class and all these things. So all these profile details can be seen over here, like the booking details can be seen over here. And if he feels that the tutor did not join the class, he can mention a message and inform admin that the tutor did not join the specific class. This is a transaction page. This My Lessons will show all his appointments, both group classes and one-on-one classes. So the My Lessons involve all the transactions for the live classes, both one-on-one class and the group class are listed over here. So it's a multi-day group class, so all the group classes are listed over here. So let me show you a completed one-on-one class. So you can see that Pranav is the student and the tutor name is Bianca, and this tutor, he has taken a one-on-one class related to a subject called hardware and it's a paid class. The class has been already completed. You go into the details page, you can see that the tutor name, class, paid lesson, all these things, payment status, everything. So since the live classes are handled through Zoom, if the tutor has a pro license, like a pro Zoom account holder, automatically the lessons are recorded and being available to both the student, tutor, and the admin after the class has been completed. And the student can access his recorded lesson from his appointments page. And I'm just gonna show you a demo of this completed lesson. And here you can see that he can access the Zoom recording of the session with the Zoom password. And he can click on this, it opens up. Let me copy this password. Yes. And he can watch the recording. So this is how the recording is captured and stored on the platform for the student, right? And here you can see the student can see the student, this is a tutor, and this is a recording available because the session has been completed already. And here you can see the lesson materials, which is uploaded by the tutor. So these are the lesson materials. He can download the lesson materials. In case if the tutor has given some sort of assignments, the tutor can download it, write the assignments and upload it back and then save the changes. Here is a review and rating from the tutor for the student. I've logged in as a student, so it's a rating and review from the tutor. I can see the tutor's review for you. These are the reviews and ratings. And I can also see, as a student, I can rate and review back the tutor. That's here. So this is a two-way reviews and ratings. Both the tutor and the student can review and rate each other after the class has been completed, right? And this is my transaction. This is my lessons for live classes. These are the my courses. So if I have purchased, as a student, if I have purchased any of the courses here, I can access them from my courses. So my courses, these are the courses which I have purchased. So I can access them. And yeah, so you can see that this is a course video. I have 17% progress has been completed. So I can access the course materials from here. If I open up, there's an audio, it shows that 34% is completed. And I can see the reviews and ratings of the tutor. So these are the reviews and ratings from different students. Yes. And this is a refund request. In case if a student wants a refund on a particular class, he can go to his My Lessons, and let's say some one-on-one class. I go here. Sorry. My transactions. I go here. I say the tutor did not join. And I can request for a refund. So here on the refund request, if I have asked for a refund, so here on my lessons, I've opened up a lesson from this tutor. I've logged in as a student, Pranav, and this is a Jonas as a tutor, and this is a class, and I can request for a refund. I can cancel the appointment and request for a refund. Cancellation are done 24 hours before the class starts, and I can mention the reason for the cancellation. And then if I initiate this cancellation, automatically a refund request will be raised here. And the refund request always goes into pending. It goes for admin's approval. The admin can accept or reject the refund request from the student. So if he approves, if admin approves the refund request, the student will be notified with an email, and he can see here that the status has been approved. And if it is not approved, he'll be seeing it here as rejected with the note or the reason for rejection. Otherwise, once the cancellation has been raised by the student, it will be in the pending status under the refund request. Okay, so this is the entire functions of the student dashboard. Now moving on to the tutor dashboard. So here I've logged in as a tutor. I've signed up already as a tutor and got my profile approved. And here I've logged in as a tutor. You can see that this is my tutor profile. I can change my tutor profile image. I can edit my tutor profile to add these information: profile, gender, phone number, country, state, city, and all these things. This is an intro video where I add the intro video of my profile, which shows up here. If you see another tutor profile, you can see this is an intro video, right? So this video, probably I'll show another tutor profile. Okay, so this is an intro video which can be added from my profile page. This is an intro video, and this introduction video will be displayed to your admin. And this is a PayPal ID, zip code. So zip code is an important factor because your students will be able to search for tutors based on the zip codes. So zip code, you can toggle on off your notifications, if update password, invite your friend. So here, the important aspect of a tutor dashboard is the tutor can also be a student. So you will be able to see all the functions of a student along with the tutor's functionalities, right? So that's the whole reason that this favorite tutor, favorite group class, favorite course. So the tutor can learn from another tutor. So that's why you have this favorite tutor, favorite group class, favorite course, and my lessons, my courses, my transactions, all these things, right? So let me show you the features of the tutor functions alone first. So this is the dashboard page of the tutor, quick links to access all these functions. This is a my message. She can see messages from different students and she can reply back to the messages. This is a my categories. This is an important part of setting up your Twitter profile. So here you set up the categories first. You can add a new category from the list of categories available. Based on that categories, you list the subjects. So I choose the category business, so I can choose the list of subjects based on the business as a category. And then I chose e-commerce, which is a subject which I would like to teach. And under subjects, I choose a list of topics which is related to the specific subject. So under e-commerce, I have Amazon FBA as the only topic. So I choose Amazon FBA and I set my price as $20 per slot. So this is how I choose my category, subjects and topics, which I'm going to be teaching. This is for the one-on-one classes, right? So I choose office productivity and the subjects are hardware and the topics is AWS certified, which I choose $15 per slot. Similarly, I can choose IT software, the list of topics, IT certification. If I want more topics, I can add more topics like web design. I can choose submit, web design subject is added, and I can choose my topic under web design, which are, for painting, I choose my subject as $15 per slot, I choose it. Then I can choose another topic, graphic design masterclass, which is at $90 per slot. So I can create under these two topics under this subject called web design. So these are the categories. Now the profile, favorite tutor, all these things, group classes. So I can create a new group class. I can set the group class as a free or a paid one. I can set the title, group class title, grades, categories, subjects, topics, number of students, maximum number of students that I'll be able to accommodate on this group class, the price, image of the group class. In case if you would like to upload some sort of course materials to get access to the students, you can upload the course materials over here and you can choose the time slots of this group class. The group class can be single day group class or a multi-day group class and a group class description. Let me show you edited group class. Okay, let me edit this group class. It's a paid group class. It's a title, grade, which this group class belongs to, grade 12 students, the categories, subjects and topics. Maximum number of students is 20, price is $8, and the available slots are this. Okay, and the description of the group class. So if I click on a particular group class, I can see the students who have booked the group classes. So I click on a particular group class, I can see that now as a student has booked this group class. Okay. And here comes my one-on-one calendar. So this is where I set the calendar, or I set my availability on my calendar. So there is like schedule and there is free session. So there are two calendars, right? The schedule is a paid session calendar. So I open up the slots on my paid session calendars. I click on this, slots are automatically created. I can create two type of slots, a 30-minute slot and a 1-hour slot. Just I have to drag it so that it automatically creates a 1-hour slot. Right. This is my paid calendar and this is my free session calendar, because I don't like to take as a tutor, I don't like to take free trial classes on the weekdays. So I keep all my free trial classes only on the weekend. So I have a separate calendar here where I choose my free trial classes slots only on the weekends, so that when student wants to book a free trial class, they'll be able to see the availability only on the weekends or on whichever days I choose to open, right? So this is a free class. So coupon, I can create coupon codes. I can enter the name code, either a percentage based discount or a fixed money discount, number of times the coupon can be used, start date and expiry date, and I can save it. Okay, these are the coupons. And the group classes are done, course one-on-one calendar is done. Next is courses. Courses are self-paced courses where tutor creates the course and they can add a new course or they can edit a course. So all the courses which as a tutor I create a course and goes for admin approval, and once admin approves it, it will be published under here on the courses listing. Okay, let me go back to my dashboard. Courses manager, I can add a new course. I can mention either it's a free course or a paid course. I can choose the categories, price, subjects, topics, grades, introduction video, course image, description. So let me, there are three more steps to be complete a course. Let me edit the existing course. Okay, so this is a course. So this is a paid course. I have entered the basic details, the description of the course, and moving on to the next step, I mentioned the course goals. You know, what will my students get after they complete this course? These are the course goals. I have to answer them. And then the lecture details, I can add as many sections as possible. There is no restriction on the number of sections or the limit of the lectures which has to be added in the course. Everything is unlimited. So I can add different sections, and under each section, these are sections, there are two sections here. Under each section, I can add multiple lectures inside the course. So I can add a lecture, I can title, description, I can mention the ordering, I can add a video file, audio and PDF. And I can see here once it is uploaded, I can edit it or I can delete it. Okay, so this is a course, and then I continue. If I like to offer some sort of discount, I can create a coupon, maximum number of types, start, end. It's a, whether a fixed coupon or a discount or a percentage discount or a fixed money discount, and then I can finish it. Once I finish it, I'll be able to, this status will show as pending. And once it goes for admin approval, and once admin approves it, it will be shows as approved. Okay, I can view the course like this on the front end. So this is the course. Once it is published, I can see the course content. Yeah. So this is the course. So one-on-one group classes is done. One-on-one classes, course manager is done. This is the course transactions. These are for the student. As I told earlier, the tutor can also be a student. So if a tutor has purchased a course from another tutor, all the course transactions will be appeared over here. My transactions, my lessons, my courses. These are my appointments. So under appointments, the tutor can see different appointment classes from different students. So a student, Pranav, has booked a one-on-one class. Its session starts at 7 p.m. Now the time is 6:40. And the class shows pending, and since Zoom has been integrated into the platform, so automatically a Zoom link icon is displayed over here on the detail page. You can see that Pranav is a student, ID certification details. This is a Zoom link. The tutor can click on this link to start the class. If tutor wants to upload some sort of lesson material, they can upload it over here, and they can see, rate and review the student after the class is done. Okay, and this is an appointments page. So here the status can vary from different. So once a session has been booked, it shows booked, and before the session starts, it turns into pending. And once the tutor clicks on the Zoom link and starts the session, the status will turn into progressing. And once the tutor completes the session, it turns into completed. Right, and if it has something like refund or cancelled, the status will change as it is, like cancelled or refunded. Okay, so these are my appointments for the tutor. The payout, so here the tutor sees a list of payouts. She can see her total earnings, how much is the commission to the website, I mean to the admin, the total earnings, and this is the earnings after commission. And she can filter by date, range, and she can send a payout request. So the tutor can choose how she would like to get paid. She can add a bank account, or she can request a payout on a PayPal. So if she adds a bank account, she has to enter her bank details and save it. If she would like to get paid via PayPal, as a tutor, I can enter my PayPal account and save it so that I can get paid via PayPal. So this is a payout. I can request for a payout by selecting whichever mode of payment I would like to get paid, and then I can submit a request. Okay, and here I can see the refund request raised by the student. Let me log out and log in as another tutor so that I can show you the payout request part. I have logged in as Jonas as a tutor profile, and I go to my payouts for the Jonas. I can see that the total earnings 128, total 102 earnings, and I can request for a payout via PayPal, and here's the request manager. So I've requested for a payout on April 17 for $66 after commission $52, and the status has been approved, right? So which means that admin has approved my payout and he has paid out. These are appointments. Yeah. So if a tutor did not start the class, the status will be showing as didn't start. So if tutor has cancelled the class, it will show as cancelled. If they have completed the class, it will show as completed. So that's the whole of tutor dashboard. So this is admin dashboard where you manage the entire platform from the admin dashboard. So this is a quick analytics about a couple of points. Here you can see the list of tutors. You can create a new tutor or you can edit an existing tutor. And here you can see the list of tutors. If you want to create a new tutor from the backend, you can create a new tutor and get it approved. Or you can see the list of tutors, their username, email, ratings and reviews, whether they are verified or whether they are featured on the homepage or they are featured on their profile tab, like a ribbon on your profile. It's a feature. Okay. So you can see if the tutor has been pending for approval, then you can edit their profile, view their information and check their documents, everything. And then you can approve them. See, this is an approved tutor. So otherwise it will show as approved instead of reject, and the status will show as pending. So you can approve or reject them. Okay. And you can see that the subjects of the tutor not updated. You can see the tutor categories, which are the categories they have chosen, how much they have priced their subjects, topics, everything. Okay. And this is a general info. So this is a list of tutors. Similarly, you can see the list of students here. You can see the list of appointments, from which tutor, which student has booked, what kind of appointments, whether it's a group class or a one-on-one class, is a paid class or a free class, whether the status is pending or booked or didn't start, all these things. So all the appointments can be seen from here. You can create, set up new grades. You can see the list of grades. You can create a new grade. You can create a new grade. Similarly, you can create new categories. So whatever the categories you create here, the tutors will be able to select from the list of categories that you created here. So list of categories and then list of subjects. You can create new subjects and you can see that the food and beverages is a subject and the category it belongs to is a lifestyle. So when you create a subject, you have to mention the category which it belongs to. Okay. Similarly, the topics. You can see the categories it belongs to, the subject it belongs to, and there's a list of topics. So when you create a new topic, you have to mention the category which it belongs to. When you mention the category, then you have to choose a subject which it belongs to. Then you can mention the topic name and create a new topic here. Okay. And here you can see the list of group classes which is created by your tutors. You can create a new group class, whether it's a free or paid. You can mention the tutor name here so that the group class goes and stores in that specific tutor profile. Similarly, just how I have showed you on how to create a group class, similar pattern on creating a group class from the admin backend. Similarly, for the list of courses, you can see that these are the courses which are submitted by the tutors, which is pending for admin approval. The admin can view a course. Sorry, let me show a, this is a dummy course. Okay, let me show a course. Okay, it's not status. Okay. So basically, when as an admin, you wanted to approve a course, you can see that the course content will be listed here. Let me go to a course which is already approved. Okay, so this course is already approved. So you can see that there's a course content, list of content inside a course. You can, once you have already approved it, you can have an option to reject the course. Okay. So you can see the list of courses here or surprise whether you want to feature a course or not feature a course and all these things. Similarly, if you want to feature a tutor, okay. So let's say here, you see that certain features are tutor, right? I mean, feature, certain tutors are featured. Here you can see that there's a featured ribbon on top of their profile, right? So you can feature them by choosing here. So for example, Dina James, you want to feature them, you just turn into feature and you refresh here, the Dina James profile will be featured. You can see your feature. Yeah, as simple as that. And the admin can create coupons. He can see the list of coupons created by different tutors. If you like to create a coupon, he can create a coupon from the back end. These are lists of static pages like terms and service, refund policy, and all these things. This is a refund request options from the students. Admin can see who are the students who have raised the refund request on which subject or a course. And so this is the refund request. Let's say a refund request is pending. He can edit it. He can see the information. He can approve or reject and mention the reason for the rejection or the reason for the note as an approval. And here is the payment manager. Payment manager is nothing but the transaction of all the transactions that has happened in the platform, be it a group class booking or a one-on-one class booking or a course purchase. All the transactions are mentioned on the same page. Okay. And then the paired request. Paired request, you can see the paired request coming in from different tutors. You will be seeing the list over here, and you can look into the list and you can either approve or reject or keep it under pending. Okay. And here you can see the list or probably the account which the tutor likes to get paid. The tutor would select the account which you like to get paid, and then she requests for a payout. So based on that, you can see the account here and you can make the payment, and you can either approve or reject or keep it pending. Okay. And this is earning stats. The earning stats shows a comprehensive one page data of the list of tutors. How much is the commission? How much is the total amount they have earned? Their earnings till date, paid till date balance, and admin earnings, and all these things. So you can export that into Excel or CSV, all these things. Okay, this is earning stats. This is a config page that explains the basic with site settings. Like, you know, you can change the site name, logo, banner, favicon, icon, and this footer information. All these footer information can be changed from here, and the sign up image can be changed from here. So here on the sign up page, you have an image here. This image you can change from here. All the footer information like social media links can be added here. If you'd like to add analytics, Google Ad Pixels, Facebook Pixel code, or any tracking codes can be added for here. The code can, before the header tag, before the body tag, can be added over here. This is for the SEO purpose. This is a commission settings. If you mention 0.2, it means 20%. If you mention 0.1, it means 10% on the commission. So here is the catch. So all the revenue, so the platform owner makes money through the commission. So whatever the sales that the tutor does, admin takes a commission out of it. So here is the default commission, which is set by the admin, which means that 10% on whatever the sales the tutor makes. If you'd like to customize for a specific tutor, then you can go to the tutor listing and you can click on the edit. And here on the commission rate, you can mention as 0.3. which means, 30% commission for a specific tutor. And if you forget to mention anything over the specific tutor, then the system automatically takes that 0.1 as a commission percentage, which means 10%. So you can set up the currency value, currency symbol. These are the technical information for setting up the platform. And on the How It Works page, there is a YouTube video, the embedded video. So you can manage it from here. These are, and you can also set up the maximum number of free trial classes per student. You can set the numbers over here. And these numbers are just configurations on the static page of Teach With Us page. On this page, you have these numbers. These are like dummy numbers. You can change those numbers from here. Okay. So this is the config page. And this is the testimonials. So on the home page, you have a testimonial block. So this testimonial block where the parents and student videos are displayed, you can manage and control the testimonial blocks from here. So you can create a new testimonial block where you can mention whether it's a parent or a student, title, enter YouTube video, image, description, all this thing. Okay. And here comes the multi-language feature. So you can see that the site can be configured on any language. The entire site will perform in a foreign language. So multi-language can be controlled from here. You can create a new language from the list of languages. You can either set a default or active. Default means the site loads default in the specific language, which I have set as English. If you keep as active, then the visitor has an option to choose from the drop-down list of languages. Okay, and you can translate the language. Let me show the Chinese file. So this is a Chinese file. There are a list of words on the left side. You have to just enter the words on the right side. So this is a multi-language file. So yeah, this is the complete feature of an admin dashboard.